What's up, everyone? I'm Aaron Soto, and today's gonna be my review on, you guessed it, Ghostbusters Afterlife, a film that I wanted to review on my channel. So let's begin. So basically what the plot is, 3 decades after the events of Ghostbusters 2, two children and their single mom moved to Somerville, Orkville, after investigating the property from their late grandfather, when the town experienced a serious planted earthquakes, the children discovered the family's link to the original Ghostbusters. And that's basically what the plot is. So, I saw this movie last year, and what do I say? It's an improvement over the god-awful 2016 film, which I can't believe I used to like that movie back in 2016, but nowadays I think it's garbage. So, let's begin the reasons why this movie rocks. The movies go back to when Ghostbusters series were left off and completely ignores the non-currently of the infamous 2016 reboot. 2, it has a lot of respects to the original Ghostbusters movies. 3, the idea of a Ghostbusters film taking place outside of New York City is interesting. 4, it has a nice nostalgic tone that connects the movies for certainties. 5, despite having a new cast in the third film, we have finally bring the most of the original cast members from the first two films, even Bill Murray, Ernie Hudson, Dan Aykroyd, Annie Potts. 6, the subjects on acting is pretty good. McKenna Grayson's in particular, it does a great entertaining performance as Phoebe. 7, amazing visual effects that were major improvements from the franchises, mostly of the shots of Egon and the film's recreation of the original Hanware performance. 8, nice soundtrack performed by Bob Simmons. 9, some of the humor is pretty funny and assuming, much like the first two Ghostbusters film. 10, Jason Reitman did a fantastic direction throughout the film. 11, the return to format for the franchise, not only some even going for as to say, it's finally broke curse that held into the franchise decades. 12, amazing magnificent photography which improves the first two Ghostbusters film. 13, the mid-credits scene with Dana, not only it's nice to see her back of one of those rare examples of that calls out someone, it's a past franchise entry hasn't aged too well without coming across as an assault towards both past and its fans. So I'm gonna give Ghostbusters Afterlife a I hope you enjoy. Bye bye, everyone.
for what?